Hey there everybody, it's Ashley. Welcome back to my channel. Today I'm going to be showing you the newest build-a-flower from Altenew, which is the Triumph Tulip, but we're also going to be talking about arranging floral stems and die cuts, which I know can be a struggle sometimes. So here we have the stamp set, and on the back you can see the layering guide, and you can see that one of the flowers actually has 5 layers, which is really great because that adds extra dimension and realism into the flower. I wanted to show you the inside of the pamphlet because I think that it's always just so beautiful. And then of course we have the coordinating dies for the sets. For my ink colors, I've got 4 different families. For the yellow flower, I'll be using Buttercream, Fresh Lemon, Caramel Toffee, Mocha, and Espresso. For the pink flower, Pink Diamond, Pinkalicious, Rubellite, and Razzleberry. For my green leaves, I'll be using Frayed Leaf, Forest Glades, and Evergreen. And then for the purple flower that's added in there, I'll be using Andromeda. So I always like to start off with a half letter size sheet of cardstock, and this is just because I can get 2 stamps out of this for each stamp, or 2 impressions for each stamp pretty much. It doesn't quite work out like that this time, but I like to have it cut this way and put in my original size Misty because I get as many impressions of these stamps as I can get, and I know that I'm going to have quite a few on this card. So I've gone ahead and lined up all of my first base, or my first layer, base layer stamps here on this sheet of cardstock, and now I'm going to use all of these different colors and the lightest shades to stamp my base color. Now that purple flower actually has only 1 layer for the actual flower itself, so I'm just using Andromeda there, and I won't need to stamp a second layer on those flowers, but it does have a leaf that accompanies it, a leaf and a stem that I'll be using there in just a second. So as you can see, I went ahead and rotated my cardstock, and this is how I get those extra impressions or those second impressions. Now, I did have some overlapping with some of my leaves, so I went ahead and took the leaf off that was overlapping and that purple flower stamp. So now I'm just going to have these 3 stamps, so the pink flower, the yellow flower, and the one of the leaves will be able to stamp twice. All of the others will just get the 1 stamp. So now I'm going to go ahead and line up my second layer on top. Now, because I've kept the stamps in the same exact place and just rotated the cardstock, I'll only have to line these up once to get both impressions, which is a really great little tip if you want to create lots of these layered stamps, because sometimes it can be pretty time consuming. So as often as you can, or as often as I can anyway, I like to stamp many of these flowers using this little technique or tip, because then I don't have to necessarily do it again next time. If I don't use all of the stamps or all of the die cuts, then there's nothing lost. I didn't really take much time, and I can just add them into my storage pocket and I'll be able to use them later. So I'm going to go through quickly now and just show you all of the layers and how the flowers just come to life with each new layer. So this is the 3rd layer, which is actually the 2nd to last layer for the pink flower and the 3rd to last for the yellow flower. Like I said, the yellow flower actually has 5 layers in this set. So now I'm going to go ahead and show you the very last layer, which is just for the yellow, and it's going to give a lot of dimension and some more shadow in there, which just helps that front petal pop up a little bit more. So now that we have our images stamped, I'm going to line up my coordinating dies, and I'll just adhere them to the cardstock with some low tack painter's tape, and just to even make sure that there's a little bit less tack than there normally would be so that it doesn't pill up any paper, I use an old Jennifer McGuire tip, which is just to rub it on my pant leg or on my arm or something like that. So after that has gone through my die cutting machine, I'm just going to easily remove all of the dies and the tape from the cardstock, and I'm able to take it off very easily because of that little Jennifer McGuire tip. And then I end up, after doing a couple more stamps, with all of these beautiful flowers. Now, it's always intimidating when you start with just a white piece of cardstock and you start to put flowers on top and try to create this beautiful bouquet that's going to make a statement and not take up too much of the card front, but take up enough of the card front. And so it takes some time to sort of put them all together and make sure that they all look nice together and that they're cohesive. My friend JC Gasper, who is on the Altenew video team with me, has taught me such an invaluable lesson of trying to create a triangle shape with your flowers or your die cut florals. And this really draws the eye and makes it so that the person can see from left to right and then all the way down to the bottom. And I just think that that was such a great tip that I learned from him, and I was able to take that with me. And sometimes it's just as simple as that. You just make a triangle shape and that's how it works. So I'm hoping that you could see a little bit there of how I arranged those florals. And I slowed it down a bit because I wanted you to see that I took that leaf and created a stem with it. I was really unsure about that at first, but it worked really well and it sort of elongated that triangle shape. And then I was able to just stick different little flowers, like that purple flower, where I wanted it coming out a little bit. And I just love the way that that bouquet came together. So now I want to add a little something. It's looking a little stark for me when I go ahead and put that bouquet on there. So to add a little bit more for the greenery, because I've got lots of pinks and yellows, some pops of purple, but I have very little green. So to bring in a little bit more greenery and to make it look a little bit more authentic, I'm going to take frayed leaf, which is the lightest green color that I used on my leaves, and I'm going to ink blend that onto the right side of my cardstock. I'd like to have it coming sort of radiating out from a center point, so not really on the edge, and then I'm going to put my bouquet right over that. I want to make sure that I get enough saturation that you can see it, but not too much that it takes over the card. I want it to be an afterthought, sort of. To add a little bit more interest and artsiness to my card, which you guys know that I love to do if you've seen any of my videos, I'm just going to add some splatter. For this, I'm going to take that same frayed leaf green color and smush it right there onto the white part of my glass mat. I'll then spray some water, pick that up with a large paintbrush, and go ahead and flick some splatter right on there. And for the finished product, you can see that I added a frame from the Lovely Frame stamp and die set from Altenew because it is just so beautiful added with florals. It's one of my favorite ways to quite literally frame a floral on a card front, and I love the way that that worked together. I hope that you've enjoyed the video. Please let me know if you have any questions in the comments. And as always, all of the products are linked in the description. Thank you so much for stopping by, and I'll see you again very soon. Thank you. Bye.